Good morning everyone, myself Indranil Mondal, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department. Today I am going to share an important topic, Gas Turbine Part 1. In this video lecture, I will teach you the basics of gas turbine, various types of gas turbine, what are the basic applications of gas turbine, advantages and disadvantages of gas turbine. Let's start the session. Basic introduction of gas turbine. Gas turbines, also called combustion turbines, a type of internal combustion engine in which burning of an air fuel mixture produces hot gases that spin a turbine to produce power. It is the production of hot gas during fuel combustion, not the fuel itself, that gives gas turbines the name. Combustion occurs continuously in gas turbines as opposed to reciprocating internal combustion engines, in which combustion occurs intermittently. The term also is conventionally used to describe a complete internal combustion engine consisting of at least a compressor, a combustion chamber and a turbine. In the gas turbine, there is a continuous flow of the working fluid. The thermal efficiency of the gas turbine is 20-30% compared with the modern steam power plant, 38-40%. In future, it is possible to construct efficiencies in and around 45%. Following are the fields of gas turbine applications: power generation, aviation, oil and gas industry, in marine propulsion. A gas turbine is used in aviation and marine fields because it itself contained lightweight, not requiring cooling water, and fit into the overall shape of the structure. It is selected for the power generation because of its simplicity, lack of cooling water, needs quick installation and quick starting. It is used in oil and gas industry because of cheap supply of fuel and low installation cost. What are the limitations of gas turbine? They are not self-starting, low efficiencies at part loads, non-reversibility, higher rotor speeds and low overall plant efficiency. History of gas turbine. We can distinguish two important types of gas turbines. There are industrial gas turbines and there are jet engine gas turbines. Industrial gas turbines were developed rather slowly. This was because to use a gas turbine, a high initial compression is necessary. This rather troubled early engineers. Due to this, the first working gas turbine was only made in 1905 by the Frenchman Ratiot. The first gas turbine for power generation became operational in 1939 in Switzerland. It was developed by the company Brown Boveri. Gas turbines had a rather low thermal efficiency, but they were still useful. This was because they could start up rather quickly. They were therefore used to provide power at peak loads in the electricity network. In the 1980s, natural gas made its breakthrough as fuel. Since then, gas turbines have increased in popularity. After World War II, the gas turbine developed rapidly. New high temperature materials, new cooling techniques and research in aerodynamics strongly improved the efficiency of the jet engine. It therefore soon became the primary choice for many applications. Currently, there are several companies producing gas turbines. The biggest producer of both industrial gas turbines and jet engines is General Electric from the USA. Rolls-Royce and Pratt and Whitney are also important manufacturers of jet engines. Working of gas turbine. They work on Brayton circle. This is a symmetric diagram of open cycle gas turbine. Air is compressed or squeezed to high pressure by a compressor. Then fuel and compressed air are mixed in a combustion chamber and ignited. Hot gases are given off, which spin the turbine wheels. This one is pressure versus volume diagram, and this one is temperature versus entropy diagram. Idealized Brayton cycle. 1 to 2 is which air is compressed, that is isentropic process, no heat exchange. 2 to 3 is combustion or heating process, that is isobaric process at constant pressure, and heat is added in 2 to 3. 3 to 4 is expansion over turbine, that is isentropic process. 4 to 1 is heat rejection process into the atmosphere in open cycle. And this one is temperature versus entropy diagram. This is the actual view of gas turbine. This one is entrance to engine core. This is gearbox. This is compressor blades. This is combustion chamber. This is turbines and this is bypass casing. What are the main components of gas turbine? Gas turbines have three main parts: air compressor, combustion chamber, and turbine. Let's discuss one by one. This is a schematic diagram of basic components of gas turbine. This one is compressor, this one is combustion chamber, and this one is turbine. Air compressor. The air compressor and turbine are mounted at either end on a common shaft with the combustion chamber between them. Gas turbines are not self-starting. A starting motor is used. The air compressor sucks in air and compresses it, thereby increasing its pressure. Use of compressed air. Primary air, that is 30%, passes directly to combustor for combustion process. Secondary air, that is 65%, passes through holes in perforated inner shell and mixes with combustion gases. Film cooling air, that is 5%, insulates or cools turbine blades. Combustion chamber. In the combustion chamber, the compressed air combines with the fuel and the resulting mixture is burnt. The greater the pressure of air, the better the fuel air mixture burns. Modern gas turbines usually use liquid fuel, but they may also use gaseous fuel, natural gas, or gas produced artificially by gasification of a solid fuel. Turbines. Hot gases move through a multi-stage gas turbine. Like in steam turbine, the gas turbine also has stationary and moving blades. The stationary blades guide the moving gases to the rotor blades and adjust its velocity. The shaft of the turbine is coupled to a generator. What are the basic classification of gas turbine? On basis of combustion process, it is classified as continuous combustion or constant pressure type. Second one is the explosion or constant volume type. On basis of path of working substance, it is classified as open cycle gas turbine and closed cycle gas turbine. On basis of action of expanding gases, it is classified as impulse turbine and impulse direction turbine. On the basis of direction of flow, it is classified as axial flow and radial flow. I will discuss open cycle gas turbine and closed cycle gas turbine in this video lecture. Open cycle gas turbine. Gas turbines usually operate on an open cycle. Air at ambient conditions is drawn into the compressor, where its temperature and pressure are raised. The high pressure air proceeds into the combustion chamber, where the fuel is burned at constant pressure. The high temperature gases then enter the turbine, where they expand to atmospheric pressure while producing power output. Some of the power is used to drive the compressor. The exhaust gases leaving the turbine are thrown out, not recirculated, causing the cycle to be classified as an open cycle gas turbine engine. Closed cycle gas turbine. It uses air as working medium. In closed cycle gas turbine plant, the working fluid, air or any other suitable gas coming out from compressor is heated in a heater by an external source at constant pressure. The high temperature and high pressure air coming out from the external heater is passed through the gas turbine. The fluid coming out from the turbine is cooled to its original temperature in the cooler using external cooling source before passing to the compressor. The working fluid is continuously used in the system without its change of phase, and the required heat is given to the working fluid in the heat exchanger. What are the basic merits and demerits of closed cycle turbine over open cycle turbine? What are the main merits? Higher thermal efficiency, reduced size, no contamination, improved heat transmission, lesser fluid friction, no loss in working medium, greater output, and inexpensive fuel. What are the main demerits? Complexity, large amount of cooling water is required, dependent system, not economical for moving vehicles as weight per kilowatt developed is high, and it requires the use of very large air heater. What are the main advantages of gas turbine engine? Very high power to weight ratio, more size efficient, moves in one direction only with fewer moving parts, low operating pressures, high operation speeds, and low lubricating. What are the main disadvantages of gas turbine engine? More expensive compared to a similar sized reciprocating engine, more complex machining operations, usually less efficient than reciprocating engines, especially at idle. Delayed response to changes in power settings. These are all about advantages and disadvantages of gas turbine engine. What are the main applications of gas turbine engine? In the field of turbojet engines, marine field, supercharging, railway engines, generation of electric power, and various industries. Application in aircraft. Nearly all the military aircrafts are powered by gas turbine. These are used for the higher generation of power in plane. These are all about the basics of gas turbine engine. If you want to get more videos, please like, share, and subscribe my channel. Thank you.